Have you ever heard of the Pareto principle? The Pareto principle basically states that in order to achieve 80% of the results, it takes 20% of the effort. One of the things often talked about with mass timber is efficient structural layouts and grids. Today, we're going to provide five different framing schemes for efficient mass timber buildings. Well, hey folks, welcome back to another Timber Talk Tuesday. I'm Ricky McLean with WoodWorks. Five framing schemes for mass timber buildings. We're going to jump into the options that you have available to you as you start a mass timber building and make sure that you're considering all of these as they might be applicable to your project. All right, let's jump right into it. The first and most common type of framing scheme for mass timber projects is post and beam. Now, from an all timber perspective, the columns and the beams are very often using glue laminated or glue lam timber, where those options are creating structural grids anywhere from rectangular, smaller grids, one-way beam systems to two-way beam systems with girders and purlins. As you can see in these images here, mass timber panels span horizontally across this beam system, whether again in a one-way or two-way direction. The thickness of that mass timber panel, whether it's CLT, NLT, DLT, etc., the thickness of that panel will be dictated partially by fire resistance ratings, partially by vibration performance, structural capability. A framing scheme like post and beam can be efficient really in just about any type of occupancy and programmatic layout. We've seen this system used very often in office buildings, higher ed, institutional, residential, especially on the taller end of things, as well as a number of other building types. All right, the second framing scheme that can be used for mass timber buildings is post and plate. Now, this is something that we've done a previous video about. If you're interested, you can check it out in the upper right-hand corner, comparing the post and beam system to post and plate. But essentially what post and plate is doing is creating a two-way slab system, very similar to two-way concrete, where it eliminates the beams. The horizontal panels, usually CLT in this case, span both directions, both the strong axis and the weak axis of the mass timber panels, and they're point supported by columns only, eliminating the beams. The third framing scheme for mass timber buildings is utilizing bearing walls. Now, these bearing walls can be mass timber or they can be light wood frame construction.
Jerry, these are load-bearing walls. They're not gonna come down.
Yeah, that's no good.
From a mass timber bearing wall perspective, we think often of some of the first international examples of what we would consider tall mass timber buildings, projects such as Forte, such as Stadhouse, where they're utilizing usually cross-laminated timber for all of the vertical supports as well as the horizontal surfaces. Here in the States, we've had projects like Candlewood Suites, part of the privatized Army Lodging Program. And as I mentioned, projects have also utilized this bearing wall approach with light wood frame construction. This is most often done in a multifamily occupancy where typical interior staggered stud walls, single stud walls, double stud walls are supporting horizontal mass timber floor plates. This is becoming much more common in the 4 to 5 story, sometimes over a podium, multifamily project. You can see several examples on the screen here of projects which have utilized this approach of light wood frame bearing walls supporting mass timber floor and roof panels. Mass timber framing scheme number 4, hybrid systems. Now, basically the idea here is that you're using several different types of structural framing materials in conjunction with each other, but still acting somewhat independently. So to give you an example of what I mean, several projects that are going more taller with mass timber, especially in the multifamily occupancy, are looking to use something like a cold form steel stud bearing wall supporting mass timber floor panels. We've also seen this hybrid approach where it's a structural steel beam and column system supporting CLT panels. We've also seen this approach with precast concrete columns and beams supporting mass timber floor and roof panels. Another example of hybrid systems in mass timber buildings that are very commonly done is where the core and or the lateral systems are using concrete shear walls, steel braced frames, in conjunction with mass timber gravity framing elements centered around those core and shaft wall areas. And rounding out number 5 of the different framing schemes for mass timber buildings is composite systems. So it's similar to hybrid in that it's using multiple different materials, But the difference here with composite systems is you're essentially blending the two materials together and they're acting as one cohesive structural unit. Some examples of what I mean here, timber concrete composite floor panels, where you have a layer, kind of a base layer of mass timber floor panel, compositely tied to a poured concrete topping layer with some type of a shear connector. So the two are acting together as one unit. That panel goes into bending, the timber is in tension, the concrete system on top goes into compression. Another composite scenario in a mass timber building could be a truss where the top and bottom cords are glue lambs. Some of the web members are steel rods or other types of steel cross sections. Again, that truss all acting together as one cohesive unit, even though it consists of several different materials acting compositely together. All right, so that's breaking down the different framing schemes available to you in a mass timber building. Of course, as we talked about at the beginning, the Pareto principle states that 80% of the results can come from 20% of the effort. Of course, that remainder 20% of the results does take quite a bit more effort. So really fine-tuning any one of these individual framing schemes is really where rubber meets the road. That's where WoodWorks comes in. We can help you fine-tune a lot of these details, set up your mass timber projects for success in a most cost-efficient manner. So feel free to reach out to us here. And in coming videos, we'll try to dive deeper in each of these individual framing schemes to help you understand how they can apply most efficiently to your projects. Well, thank you so much for making it to the end of today's video. And until next time, we'll see you later.